How's this season going, Tom?
Well, this season has been not only because the lovely Brooke has joined me, but also because I think we learned from our season 9, which frankly wasn't our strongest, how to bring the show back to its basics, which was fewer couples, tighter production, and the response from viewers has been great. I hasten to add that we've beaten American Idol in the ratings a few times.
How'd you explain that, by the way? Really?
More people watched us than them.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah,
I see.
Yeah.
I
that
see.
Was basically
you
how that happened.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Well,
yes, obsessively.
Brooke, did you want to become part of the show? I mean, you won it.
I did. You know, it's an amazing experience for me as a host professionally to be able to come back to a place where I really have so much compassion for what the dancers are going through. It brings a whole other element to what I do because I've been in their shoes.
Yeah.
And I think for a woman as a host, this is the most glamorous gig on television. So
is there a lot of backbiting backstage, Tom? Is this very competitive off?
You don't see it, do you? If there is, they keep it from us. I've never seen any real. I mean, you're more apt to get the tension in the back room.
I think I experienced something different than you experienced, but I think people would be surprised at what a family affair it is, really, because when you take celebrities and you strip them down and they're so vulnerable and they're doing something that they've never done before, there's a lot of support, actually, and I think many people are competing against themselves, and even though everybody wants to get that coveted Mirrorball trophy, there's applaud, there's support, everybody is just, there's a lot of love in the celeb aquarium.
Yeah, sometimes it's a family affair. In isolated cases, it's just an affair.
Mr. Quipster, a lot of this season's drama, by the way, seemed to center on reality TV star Kate Gosselin. Take a look.
You're not hearing what I'm saying.
Don't come back and then just do basically hardly anything.
Kate and Tony.
I had the opportunity. I'm very, very honored to have been here.
Brooke, did she have fun?
I hope she had fun. I think this was such a challenge for her that sometimes the emotions that go into really putting the dance together live consumes you. I think she probably learned a lot about herself. We had fun being with her. You know, there was so much negative press centered around Kate, and I actually think she was lovely. I think she was going through a really difficult time in her life, but I never saw that side of Kate that everybody wrote about. Never.
You too, Tom?
Yeah, I was totally charmed by her. I had never seen the John and Kate plus 8 show, so I didn't have that backstory. And the Kate that I encountered, was self-deprecating, had a very easy smile, and was working through some real anxiety about getting out there and dancing live. And I think by the end, and I think her tears prove that, she was emotionally invested.
You and Ryan Seacrest, you have two similar roles here, hosting very popular shows that are competitive. What's your role?
I think to keep the trains running on time, basically, you know?
A timekeeper.
Yeah, kind of, to keep the show on the rails and also to, I feel very protective of the couples, so if I feel like the judges have really come at them a little too strong, I go back at them.
What's your role, Brooke?
Well, you know, I spend most of my time back in the celeb aquarium with them. So, you know, I get them when they've just come out of performing live, either getting bashed or getting praised. So I get the very emotional side of them. And I really want to support them and kind of hold that together in there. And I also, because I've been through the process, I completely understand what they're going through.
I
want people to see that side of them, of what really goes on behind the scenes and what they're going through to make this show happen.
Well, I think she has the toughest job, in all honesty, because she's... You're trying to engage them in conversation when they're either still bristling about the judge's comments.
Sometimes they might not want to talk.
Right.
Sometimes they're overwhelmed. I remember after I would come off the dance floor with Derek, your adrenaline is so high, sometimes you couldn't even hear the question because you're in your own zone. So I'm very, very sensitive to all that, but it's delicate. Sometimes I just want to hug them and maybe not talk to them. Sometimes I want to let them vent. Sometimes I want them to let people know what's really going on, and I need to get those votes for them because they're all working so hard.